So that means finding a hash value with certain properties is expected to require an amount of work. And by adjusting those properties, we can increase the amount of work. So this is what Bitcoin does. So in order to create a new block, which would validate the next history of transactions, it's necessary to find some value x such that the hash of the state concatenated with x is less than some target. You keep increasing the value of x until you find one that satisfies that property. And that provides the time step that allows a new block to be generated. So this is the idea Bitcoin uses to generate a timestamp, is you have to keep finding new blocks, and a block will validate a set of transactions. But to generate a new block, you've got to find a new timestamp, which is this target. So you've got to find a value where the hash of the state concatenated with that value. And the state does two important things. It includes information about the previous block. So this is how the timestamps form a chain, that the state must include the previous block. It also includes some information that's likely to be unique for each member of the network. This is how they avoid it being the case that they're all racing to find the same value x. So given those properties, then the goal is to find the value x that you can concatenate with that to be less than some target. And the value of the target controls how hard it is to find. And the way the Bitcoin currency is designed to work is this value of the target is adjusted in a way that makes the time to find x keep about 10 minutes. That's the time for the whole network to find the next value. So that value of the target will keep decreasing as the computing power in the network increases. And if you go to the Bitcoin website, you can see the current value of the target, which is this value, that in order to create a new block, you've got to find an x value such that this property is less than the target. And I should emphasize that these zeros are not just one bit. This is hex, so each one of these zeros is 4 bits. So you've got to find a value where the hash starts with 54 zeros, followed by something less than 1011 and more. So if you found a value that hashed where the result started with 55 zeros, or started with 54 zeros, a 1, 0, and a 0, well, then you'd be golden. You'd be able to create the next block. That would allow you to earn the value of a new block, which currently is 50 bitcoins. Each bitcoin is worth about $5. So finding a hash that hashes to this would be worth about $250. And the rest of the network can verify that. It can compute the same hash function, verify that for the x value that you found, the value is less than the target, and that will add that block to the Bitcoin network. So the difficulty of finding such hashes keeps decreasing. The reason it's so low is because of using GPUs. If you're using a regular processor, it would use far more than $250 in computing power to find such a hash value. If you have a GPU, there are algorithms for implementing the hash function more efficiently. That would mean that finding a value that satisfies this property should require about that much value in computing power. So to see if this makes sense, I want to ask why the timestamp function, the one here to find the next block, uses two hashes instead of one. Here are the choices. See if you can figure out which one would make the most sense as to why there are two hash functions here.